This is a pre-built version of the application. So if we go ahead and run it, and we'll have three peers. This will be the first one, and this is the second one, and this the third one. And the first one will have this port number, and the second one, this one. And the third, this one. And this guy will pick up messages from those two peers. And this one from those two. And this one from those two. I will start by creating a new project. And I downloaded this to do JSON. So we go to properties and Java build path. And here we will have four classes, a peer class with a main method, and this will spawn PeerThreads, and one ServerThread, which would in turn spawn ServerThreadThread. So this will extend the thread class, and this one also, and this one. And here we will prompt the user for input, and pick up that input and split it. So we'll pick up the username and the port number, and going to server thread, we will have two instance variables, a server socket and a set of server thread threads. and the constructor will take in a port number, and we will use that to initialize the server socket. And coming back here, we will instantiate a server thread passing in this port number, and call the start method, which will end up triggering a call to the run method when the operating system decides to do so. And let's go ahead and add a get method for this set. And here we need a method to update the peers that this peer is picking up messages from. And we will call it so it takes in the username that we picked up here, and the server thread that we instantiated here, and a buffered reader that we will use to pick up input from the user. So each peer will be represented as a host name and port number. Now the peer thread will have a buffered reader instance variable, and its constructor will take in a socket. And it will use that socket to get the input stream, and use that to get input stream reader, and use that to get the buffered reader. And going back here, let's have this method for sending messages. So same as this one. Takes in a buffered reader and a username and a server thread, and we will end up calling it from this method. So here, if the user entered S, we would skip. Otherwise, we do a split, so we pick up the host name and the port number. So here, we instantiate a socket, passing in the host name and the port number. And we do that for all the peers, which are space separated. And we have a peer thread instance for each peer, and we pass in this socket, and we call the start method. On each peer thread, which end up calling the run method when the operating system decides to do so. So here we pick up JSON messages from other peers and print out their username and the message. And in ServerThread, we need a method for sending messages, and we will end up calling it from here. So the user can enter E to exit or C to add peers to pick up messages from. So C triggers a call to the update listen to peers method, and if the user didn't enter either of those, then we go ahead and pack the message, so we have the username and the message that we picked up here, and we send that message through the server thread. And before finishing the coding of this class, let's go here and add this code. So this class will have a socket instance variable and a print writer and a server thread, and we will initialize the socket and the server thread using the constructor. And this is just a get method for the print writer. And now here we can use the print writer to send messages. So we're picking up the print writer here on each one of the server thread threads that are in this set. And this is the code for the run method. So we have a server thread thread for each one of the peers, and we put those in this set. And call the start method on each one of those threads, which end up triggering a call to this run method when the operating system decides to do so. And finally, let's do a test run of the application. So let's maybe have four peers. And let's have this one be the first one, and this the second one, and third one, and the fourth one. and maybe this peer have this port number, and this one this port number. And let's maybe have this peer picking up messages from those three peers. And maybe this one, let's do a skip here. And maybe this one is picking up messages from those two peers. And this one from this peer. So those two are picking up messages from four, 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 one, and this one is not picking up messages from anybody. And only this one is picking up its messages. And the messages from this one. And those two are picking up messages from this guy. So let's maybe exit here and here. And let's maybe have a new peer. And maybe this one have this port number. And it's picking up messages from those two peers. So it can receive messages, but it cannot send messages. So let's do a change here. Now this is picking up the messages that this one is sending.